This was a mom who spent 8 days in Ursula with her kid. She told me a story about a little boy who was 4 who had a fever, and the guards doused him in cold water and then left him for an hour on the floor in his underwear, you know, crying. And when his mom wanted to put a blanket over him, they screamed at her and wouldn't let her and said, "Who's the boss in here? Is it the kid or is it us?" I spent 5 days in the Rio Grande Valley visiting a mixture of courts, detention centers, shelters, respite centers, and also this bus station. A common thread that came through people's stories was deliberate humiliation, sort of deliberately making people seem like poor and dirty and almost like animals. The toilets are out in the open and they're overflowing with sewage. There's never enough food. Moms I spoke to said that, you know, they weren't allowed to breastfeed their kids. Guards are often verbally abusive and racist. What I saw when I was working in Rio Grande Valley was bureaucracy being weaponized to keep journalists as far away as possible from the immigrants that they were trying to cover. ICE and Border Patrol and also the Executive Office of Immigration Review, these bureaucratic figures, they rely on the press being intimidated and press not knowing their rights to try to keep them from exposing these truly horrendous things that those agencies are doing. I had received permission to report on a courthouse that was run by the Executive Office of Immigration Review. I go in, I draw. The next day, I get a very irate email from the Executive Office of Immigration Review that a separate set of approval needs to be obtained for sketching in advance, and sends me a ruling threatening federal penalties for unauthorized sketching. The thing is, though, that when you're an artist, you have a few workarounds. Eventually, I was allowed to go in because it's my right as a member of the public, but they had someone watching to make sure that I didn't sketch. Thus, words can make lines, and lines can make images. While everything that these agencies had jurisdiction over was highly censored, there were so many places that you could just talk to immigrants after they got out of detention. So I spent a lot of time at this bus station in McAllen. At that bus station, because I drew, because I didn't have a big camera, I was able to make pictures of immigrant moms breastfeeding their kids. For a photographer to take this picture, it would, I feel like it would be much harder for him to get the trust to take that sort of picture than it was for me to draw. And I feel really honored and grateful that she let me do that. What I saw at that bus station was a lot of very petite Central American mothers with giant ankle monitors strapped to their ankles that severely limited the amount of clothing that they could wear and that had already left bruises and scrapes all over their feet after about 6 hours and that they were going to be stuck with for 6 months. Ankle monitors that you had to plug in every 12 hours. So that's the sort of giant pack, which also comes with like a battery pack. It has all these parts. And that was her, one of the Honduran ladies, literally like shackled by her ankle monitor to the wall. And these are all, there's contracts with private companies that make obscene profits for them. This woman, her name is Doña, and her little boy was stolen from her on June 11th. A little 5-year-old boy that she was coming with, along with her 8-year-old niece. The way they took them was they told all the parents, like, you just need to see a judge, and then once you are done, we're gonna take you right back to where your kids are. And instead, what they did was they took her in shackles to another detention center, they took her little boy, William, to Los Angeles, and they took her niece to New York. And she didn't get her boy back for about 5 weeks. And this was Doña at the airport, the moment that she and her son were reunited. I drew that as fast as I could, and this little boy just jumped on her, you know, he's so happy to see her. She hugged him so hard. Man, kids are resilient. I would hang out, and I would very often just draw alongside kids for hours. And, you know, these, like, little boys and girls, they had just been locked in horrible, crowded cages with their parents for days, and yet they're like dancing ballet and drawing pictures of gymnasts and mermaids, and you know, just being kids. And I think as much as I was horrified by the inhumanity of what was being done to these immigrants at the border, I was also impressed by their strength and their resilience. Power always wants to censor what it's doing. Power does not allow photographers into courtrooms, and it doesn't allow them into prisons or detention centers. But art can work around those constraints. I think my through line is a dislike of people in authority that are doing wrong to others, doing wrong to those who are powerless. And I think that perhaps more than anything else, that desire to challenge authority unjustly deployed is behind my motivation as a journalist, and I think a lot of other journalists as well.